Hello everyone, welcome back to your online classes. Children, I'm sure you must have enjoyed your summer holidays with your near and dear ones. I'm very happy to see that few of the students who were not able to do their assignments because of reasons like book not available or so have finally done so. There are many students who have completed all their 8 assignments and have submitted them. So a big round of applause for those students who have completed all their assignments. Okay. Now children, before continuing with the syllabus, let me tell you few things about your upcoming first term exams. First thing, your first term exam will be an offline exam. In other words, it will be a written exam like we had last year. We had our half yearly and our final exams. The same way we'll be having our first term exams. Okay, it will be a written exam. You will be getting answer sheets from the school in which you'll have to attempt your question paper. Okay. Second thing, the written exam will be of 40 marks. Okay. And the paper will be based on whatever topics we have covered or will be covering in the next 2 videos. Okay, so all in all, your syllabus will be based on the 10 assignments that you will be doing before the starting of the first term exam. Okay, that was about the written exam. Now the home assignments that you are doing, the homework which you are doing, that homework will be scored out of 20. Okay, so if you remember last time also the assignments were scored, okay, this time also the assignments are scored. So you have 10 assignments. Okay, so you can calculate that each assignment will be of 2 marks. So if you have done all 8 assignments completely, correctly, neatly, then you will be getting the complete 20 marks. Okay. Your written exam will be starting from most probably by 26th of July. Okay. And your 10th assignment will be over by the 17th of July. Okay, that means this week and this week you will be getting your 9th assignment, and next week you will be getting your 10th assignment. Okay, so all these assignments from 1 to 10 will be scored 2 marks for each assignment. Okay, so if in case in any subject you have left an assignment, make sure to complete that assignment and send it. One more thing, children, if you must remember, if you are sending an incomplete assignment, you cannot expect full marks for that assignment. You'll be getting your answer sheet from the school, which you will be asked to collect on a particular day. You will be informed about it in your WhatsApp school WhatsApp group. Okay, so make sure that the number which you are using, okay, the same number is registered in your current diary. Otherwise the problem arises that a message has been sent, but because that number is the one which is used by your father or your mother, you do not come to know about it. So make sure that the number which you are using or which is registered in current diary is the same number through which you have been added in your school WhatsApp group. Okay, so that was the information regarding your first term exam, and now let us continue with our syllabus. Okay, so I'll be starting with the English literature. But before doing that, let me tell you the answers of the 8th assignment, that is the language portion, which you were given to do. The purpose of me telling you the answers of the previous assignment is that in case you have done any mistake, you can correct them, or if you were unable to do it because you were not able to understand or because there was nobody to help you out with your homework, then you can listen to these videos and complete your assignment. Okay, so let us start with the answers of the 8th assignment. Children, your 8th assignment was from English language, chapter number 2, nouns, and you were asked to do all the exercises of this chapter. Okay, now you have been doing nouns since class 1, so I'm sure you must not have found much difficulty in writing the answers of the exercises. Okay, but still, let me tell you the answers so that you can cross check your answers with mine. Okay, so let us start. Now from page number 12, exercise A was identify the different kinds of nouns in the following sentences and name them. Whenever such a question comes, always remember that a sentence may have more than one noun. In that case, if there are 5-6 nouns also, then also you have to identify them and name them out of the 5 types of or the 6 types of nouns, which noun is the one that you have identified. Okay, so the first sentence was Virat Kohli is a good batsman. In this sentence there are 2 nouns. One is Virat Kohli, a proper noun, and second is batsman, common noun. Number 2, Harsha Bhogle has a good knowledge of cricket. Again, proper noun is Harsha Bhogle and common noun is cricket. Number 3, Birbal was a man of great wit. Birbal is a proper noun and man is a common noun. Number 4, for making the sweets we need sugar, milk and honey. Okay, so sweets, sugar, milk and honey are all common nouns. Okay, next, number 5, a herd of cattle greeted the farmer in his backyard. So in this sentence, herd is collective noun, farmer and backyard is common noun. Number 6, the army defeated the enemies. Army is a collective noun and enemies is a common noun. Number 7, he is an Indian. Here Indian is proper noun. Number 8, Sally is a good singer. Sally, proper noun, singer, common noun. Number 9, Rita ate an orange. Rita, proper noun, orange, common noun. Number 10, the chain is made of gold. Chain, common noun, gold, material noun. Okay, or you can say concrete noun. B exercise. In the B exercise, the question was write suitable collective nouns for the following using the help box. In the box there were words given, collective nouns were given, and you had to use them in proper place. Okay, so the first one is a clump of trees. Number 2, a swarm of bees. Number 3, a shoal of fish. Number 4, a school of whales. Number 5, a string of pearls. Number 6, a litter of puppies. Number 7, a pride of lions. And number 8, a fleet of ships. Number 9, a herd of cows. Number 10, a series of books. Number 11, a flock of birds. Number 12, a bouquet of flowers. Number 13, a range of hills. Number 14, a bunch of keys. And number 15, a band of musicians. Okay. Now exercise C, you were asked to pick out common nouns from the sentence, and then you were asked to make sentence, your own sentence of that common noun. Okay, so the first sentence was Savita is a good girl. In this, girl is the common noun, and then from girl you had to make a sentence. For example, the girl is going to market. Okay, number 2, Mr. Sharma is a doctor. Here common noun is doctor. So the sentence you can make out of doctor is, there are multiple sentences. The easiest one is a doctor helps sick people. Number 3, these are some books for you. So the common noun is books. Okay, then you make your own sentences. The remaining common nouns, I'll not be telling you the sentences. Okay, number 4, the table is round. Common noun is table. Number 5, this is a cold month. Common noun is month. Number 6, these mountains are very beautiful. Common noun is mountains. Number 7, he is a naughty boy. Common noun is boy. Number 8, her aunt is coming today. So the common noun is aunt. So all these common nouns you have to use in your own words to make a sentence, which you will do on your own. And remember, if a question has got two parts, you must attempt both the two parts. Okay, both the parts. Number 9, he is an honest man. Common noun is man. And last one, the earth is round. Common noun is earth. Okay. Then is D. Sorry. Okay. Then it's the D one. Exercise D, in the bracket, written in blue ink, are few words, and you were asked to form abstract nouns out of those words to complete the sentence. Okay, so I'll be just telling you the abstract nouns formed from those words. Okay, the first one was brave, so the noun will be bravery. Number 2 was free, the abstract noun is freedom. Long, length, protect, protection, marry, marriage, safe, safety, just, justice, invent, invention, honest, honesty, and clever, cleverness. Okay. Now from page number 14, again in exercise A, which was of countable and uncountable nouns, you were asked to tell whether the underlined word is a countable noun or an uncountable noun. Okay. Now countable nouns are those nouns which you can count in numbers. Okay. And uncountable nouns are those nouns which you cannot count. So the first one is, he used the computer. The first one, the two words have been underlined. One is computer and one information. Computer, you can count computer, how many computers are there in a room. So it's a countable noun. Information is an uncountable noun, because how much information a person has, you cannot count them. Okay. In number 2, the underlined word was sand. So it's an uncountable noun, because you cannot count how much grains of sand or particles of sand are there. Okay. Number 3, furniture. Again, furniture is like sofa, table, bench, chair. So you can always count them. So it's a countable noun. Number 4, seat. Seat is again a countable noun. Number 5, radio. Radio is again a countable noun. Number 6 is advice. Advice is an uncountable noun, because you cannot keep a count of that. Okay, number 7, picture. It's a countable noun. Music, it's uncountable noun. Rice, it's uncountable noun, because you can always say I had a plate of rice or I had a spoon of rice. So in that way, when you say something like this, you are actually counting the number of spoons. You're not counting the grains of the rice. You cannot count how many grains of rice you ate in your lunch. So rice is an uncountable noun. And the last one was jelly beans. Jelly beans is again uncountable noun. Okay. In exercise B, you were asked to underline proper nouns, common nouns, and collective nouns. Okay. Now, there are some words which have been repeated in the sentence, so you do not have to underline them every now and then. So you just have to underline them once. Okay. The first one is Pulkit. Okay. Then Mansi, Kittu, parents, father, doctor, mother, housewife, family, uncle, aunt, cousins, engineer, doctor, again it's been repeated, Aman, okay, sisters, and nuclear family. So these are the nouns which were used in the paragraph. Okay. And the last exercise was of two, there were two exercises left from page number 15. One was, arrange the following nouns in two lists, that a few words were given to you and you had to arrange them in columns, like these are the countable nouns and these are the uncountable nouns, like you had already done in your previous class. Okay. The first one is poetry. Poetry is uncountable. House, countable. Book, countable. Milk, uncountable. Ink, uncountable. Courage, uncountable. Season, countable. You can count how many seasons are there. Coffee, uncountable. Medicine, uncountable. Gold, uncountable. River, countable. You can count how many rivers are there in the world. Okay. And dust is again uncountable. And the last exercise was that you have to choose the correct words and make complete sentences. Okay. So I'll be just telling you the answers. The first one is, there were many birds in the sky. Number 2, much wheat is grown in India. Number 3, Farid has 2 bags of sugar in his shop. Number 4, all the people cried for freedom. And number 5, these bars are made of iron. Okay, so these were the answers of your 8th assignment, and now I'll be starting with the second chapter of your English literature book, that is The Overcoat. The chapter The Overcoat is written by Ruskin Bond, who's an Indian author. He's a very famous Indian author. The story is about a young man who had recently shifted to a hill station. He was invited by one of his neighbors to a Christmas party. So when he was on his way to the party, he met someone on the way, and the story is about the experience that he had after meeting that person. Okay, so let us begin with the chapter. To read the chapter, you have to open page number 17 of your English literature course book. So let's start with the reading. It was clear, frosty weather, and as the moon came up over the Himalayan peaks, I could see that patches of snow still lay on the roads of the hill station. The young man was walking on road. It was night time. The moon had come up. It was a full moon night, and the weather was clear, but it was quite frosty. It was quite chilly because it had snowed earlier. And even though it was night time, due to the moonlight, the young man was able to see patches of snow on the road. I would have been quite happy in bed with a book and a hot water bottle at my side, but I had promised the Kapadias that I'd go to their party, and I felt it would be churlish of me to stay away. The young man would have been very happy staying at home, reading a book in his bed, lying down comfortably with a hot water bottle beside him to keep himself warm. But Kapadias had invited him. He was new to that place. Kapadias, being their neighbor, they had invited him to the Christmas party, and it would have been very rude of the young man to say no to them. Okay, so not to be churlish, not to be rude, the young man accepted the Kapadia's invitation, and that was the reason why he was out on such a cold night. I put on 2 sweaters, an old football scarf and an overcoat, and set off down the moonlit road. To protect himself from the cold weather, the young man wore 2 sweaters, an overcoat. He had a football scarf round his neck in order to protect his neck from the cold wind, and he started walking towards Kapadia's house. It was a walk of just over a mile to the Kapadia's house, and I had covered about half the distance when I saw a girl standing in the middle of the road. The Kapadia's house was not very far from where the young man lived. It was almost a mile away, and the young man had almost completed half of the distance when he saw a girl standing in the middle of the road all alone. She must have been 16 or 17. She looked rather old-fashioned. She looked rather old-fashioned. Long hair hanging to her waist, and a flummoxy sequined dress, pink and lavender, that reminded me of the photos in my grandmother's family album. The young man guessed that the girl must be around 16 or 17 years old. The way she was dressed up, she looked rather old-fashioned because she was wearing a flummoxy sequined dress, which was sparkling under the moonlight. Her hair was long, it was till her waist, and looking at her, it reminded the young man about the photos that he had seen in his grandmother's family album. When I went closer, I noticed that she had lovely eyes and a winning smile. "Good evening," I said. "It's a cold night to be out." "Are you going to the party?" she asked. "That's right, and I can see from your lovely dress that you are going too. Come along, we are nearly there." When the young man got closer to the girl, he noticed that she had lovely eyes and a winning smile. Winning smile means that the way she was smiling, it was quite innocent, and anybody could trust her. She could win the trust of anyone. So, in general, the young man, that is the narrator, he started conversing, he started talking to the girl, and he started with wishing her good evening, and then he simply says that it's quite cold night to be out like that for a girl of her age. So the girl asked the narrator that, are you going to the party? To which the narrator said, yes, I am going to the party, and the way you are dressed, it seems as if you are also going to the same place where I am going. So he invites the girl to join him, and he says that, okay, let's walk together, because we are almost there. Almost there means we are about to reach the Kapadia's house. She fell into step beside me, and we soon saw lights from the Kapadia's house shining brightly through the deodars. The girl told me her name was Julie. I hadn't seen her before, but I'd only been in the hill station a few months. So the girl starts walking along with a young man, and as they were approaching the Kapadia's house, they could clearly see that from a distance through the deodar trees, they could clearly see that the Kapadia's house was shining brightly. It was well decorated, because it was a Christmas party, so they had beautifully decorated their house according to the occasion. And while on their way, during the conversation, the girl introduced herself, and she told the young man that her name was Julie. The young man thought for a moment that he has never seen her before. Since the day he has shifted to this station, he has never seen her before. But then he realizes that it has that few months only he has, it has been just recent, only few months have passed since he has shifted in this hill station. So maybe it was quite obvious, it was quite possible for him of not knowing all the people who live in that area. Once they reach the party, what happens? How it became an unforgettable experience for the young man, we'll read about it in our next video.